Hi, everybody, and welcome to another installment of the Google Ads Developer Series. My name is Devin, and I'll be your guide as we walk through episode 3 of the Authentication and Authorization Series. In previous episodes of this series, we've learned a lot, including what OAuth is, what the different types of flows are, including the desktop application flow and the web application flow. We discussed how to generate credentials such as your client ID, client secret, and developer token. And we even saw how to generate a refresh token using the OAuth Playground. In this episode, we'll be generating a refresh token using the desktop application flow in one of our client libraries. For this example, we'll be using the client library for Java, but keep in mind this is just for demonstration purposes. The methodology and steps that we follow here will be the same or at least very similar no matter what client library you're using. So with that, let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is open up my IDE, head into the examples directory within the client library, and then the authentication subdirectory, and I'll open up the authenticate in desktop application class file. Now as I do that and scroll down, you'll see there are placeholders for my client ID as well as my client secret. If you don't know how to generate these, check out some of the earlier episodes in this series. But what I'll do here is just copy and paste those in and run the example. Now, as you can see, the console produces a URL. So I'll follow that URL. And here I can authenticate using an email address. Now, keep in mind, the email address here that you authenticate as is important, because the access level of the refresh token that's generated will match the access level of the email address on the Google Ads account. So I will authenticate here, log in, and now I'll click Allow to enable the application to manage my Google Ads account on my behalf. And when I do so, you can see this produces a code. So I'll copy this code, paste it back into my console where I was prompted, hit enter, and now you can see pretty much the entire contents of a configuration file. I have my client ID and the client secret, which I provided earlier. Here's the important part, the refresh token that was newly generated, and you can see placeholders for some other items such as developer token. Now once I fill in all of those placeholders, I can just copy and paste the contents here into my config file. Now in Java, that would be an ads.properties file. So once I do that, I can go ahead and begin making API calls against the Google Ads API with the client library for Java. And because the client libraries do a lot of the heavy lifting for you with regard to authentication specifically, I actually won't have to worry about that refresh token going forward because it's stored in my configuration file. Now, as you can see, this process was pretty easy, hopefully fairly straightforward, and that's part of the reason why we suggest using the desktop application flow. I hope this episode has been useful to you and you've learned quite a bit, but feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can check out future episodes. For example, in the next episode of this series, we'll demonstrate the same process using the web application flow. And as always, if you have questions, please reach out to us on the support channels. I'll see you next time.